everybody to the 2020 Music Awards. What a strange year this has been, but it's going to have memories for a lifetime. We'd like to add to those memories by sharing with you what each of your children or students have done in this past year. And I have to say, the band is such, and the music department as a whole, choir is such a big part of this school community. If you think of football games, sing the Star-Spangled Banner, you think about Veterans Day, normally graduation, we play a big part in all the kids around you. And I think you should feel really good about that, really proud about that, because that's a really big deal, I think. As you know, this is my last year, and I'm going to be retiring again. I feel a little bit of what the seniors feel, things that I hoped that would happen that didn't happen. But the great thing is about music is it always plays a role in your life. And the memories that we made in the classroom, out on the streets, on stages, performing, those are the memories that matter. And so as we go forward, of course, we take those memories with us. I have many of them. I've gone through them in the last weeks and looked at pictures and books and videos. It's just been a really exciting time, and I hope that you feel the same way. So before we actually head forward, there are a group of people that we do need to thank. So many involved, you know, some people say just one person does this, but one person doesn't do this. I feel like I've been blessed with angels for the last 30 years, that people show up and say, hey, do you need help with your uniforms? Boom, there they are. And many of them, I'll just use uniforms as an example, many of those people have put in not just a year or two or four, but 10 years and longer even. And we really appreciate all the people involved. Even as we're here, two nights ago, we had an opportunity to Zoom with all the board members in the Booster Club, and they're already looking ahead and thinking about how they can progress. There are always openings for any parents that want to do that, but our Booster Club people is the lifeblood. As a matter of fact, all the awards that we're going to announce today come from them. They pay for them. So we just think that's really important. As we move forward today, we'll explain what each kid gets in the awards, and hopefully you'll understand how important it is. But I do want to thank also our administration. Even today when we were setting up for this, Mr. Holmes was in here saying, hey, try this, try that idea. What do you think of that? I mean, we've just been super supported here, and I think that's one of the reasons I decided to stay at Kingsford and to work at just because they said you're important, your program is important, and that makes all the difference. So a great big thank you to our administration, to our Board of Education, and of course to you parents. Without you, these kids probably wouldn't make it to performances and concerts. They'd be half-dressed or not ready to roll at all. Oh, I forgot my instrument. How many times you had to get in your car and run it down there at the last minute? I mean, it's just an amazing thing. Parents, you know, this one time you can pat yourself on the back. We really appreciate all that you've done. So I would like to do a special thank you, though, to a woman who has been here, gosh, at least 19 or 20 years out of this 30 I've been here. She's practically a staff member. She's known by so many people. And I want to give a special thank you and recognition to Maxine Nowak. Actually, Mr. Galindo and I make it look like we've done an awful lot putting this all together, but Mrs. Nowak has gone through and bundled all the awards. They're all together, and you'll be able to pick those up. The school will be announcing when you can pick up awards, and they'll come in. They'll all be packaged together. She did that all herself, ordered the awards. Then she went through and made this beautiful slide presentation. No, she didn't put her own picture in there. I did that because I thought that would be appropriate. But I just want you to know that when you see her in the future times when we're meeting back here at school, give her a great big thank you, because without her, this whole thing just wouldn't come together. So, that being the case, and that being my outgoing speech, my being the last one, this is Mr. Galindo's first.
Sure is.
And I'm really excited at all the things we're going to see in the future. But for now, he's going to announce our ninth grade You might want to tell them what they get too.
Yeah, absolutely. So, freshmen, incoming freshmen, we are celebrating your first completed year in the music department. And do we have that?
I'll get an
example. Each year, you're going to be getting something different for staying within our music department. And Mr. Shirk's going to bring up a board, but the first year, I believe, we get pins. Is that right? So each of the freshmen will be receiving a pin that you will be able to wear or hang up wherever you'd like. Here he comes now. So this board, as you see, will outline not only just the first year, but the second, third, and fourth years for those of you who can stay in all 4 years. The second year is, do you want to point to where the second year is?
Our second year is,
there we go,
the pins.
Okay, so second year is the pins. Third years are the
third year is
K.
Right.
Right, and the fourth year is the big plaque that you see.
Correct.
Perfect. Good deal. There's also some other bonuses for solo ensemble, which is the ribbons up on top. There are also solo ensemble pins as well. There are jazz band bonuses and pep band bonuses, also depending on how many years you're in there.
Correct.
So, from here on out, I guess we're going to go through each student individually, starting with the ninth grade. So, first up, we have Annalie Aho in band for 1 year and also performed with the clarinet choir, which received a 1. Next up will be Zane Cady. Zane was in band for 1 year, also performed with the percussion ensemble, and they received a star 1. There is, at solo ensemble, there's 2 levels. All the grades you'll be seeing today are at the district level. That means the local level that was held here at KHS. This year, we weren't able to go to state, but some students were able to hold the first ever virtual state performances, and those students did incredibly well. But more on that later. Next up, we have James Kane, who was in chorus for 1 year and performed with the high school show choir. They received a 1. After that, we have Charles Christensen. He was in band for 1 year, performing with the saxophone ensemble to receive a star 1. Carolyn Sutton-Husky was in band and chorus for both 1 year, performing with the clarinet ensemble and the concert show choir, for receiving a 1 for both ensembles. We then have Melanie DeCellier for band 1 year and pep band 1 year as well. She performed in the clarinet choir, also receiving a 1. Joshua Freeman was in band for 1 year, performing with the low brass ensemble, receiving a star 1.
Small correction there, big guy. Joshua Early, not Freeman.
Woo!
Oh, Josh Freeman is a senior trumpet player.
Looks like I need some glasses.
That's okay. Man. You're forgiven.
Huh. Hey, I'm the new guy. Isn't that the
yeah, that's right.
All right, so that was Josh Early in band 1 year, low brass ensemble, star 1. That makes much more sense. Madeline Edwards, in band for 1 year, clarinet choir, receiving a 1, but she also did a clarinet solo, which she received a 2. Sylvie Ellis was in band for 1 year, performing with the saxophone ensemble and receiving a star 1. We also have Delaney Fortner, in band for 1 year, in pep band for 1 year, and performing with the flute ensemble, receiving a star 1. Lexi Friedrich is in band for 1 year, but was also chosen to partake in honors band. She performed with the trumpet ensemble and received a star 1. Ryan Boucher, in band for 1 year, in pep band for 1 year, and performing with the French horn ensemble to receive a star 1. Aiden Geronimi, in band for 1 year, performing with the trumpet ensembles, receiving a star 1. Bryce Greneveld, in band for 1 year, performing with the saxophone ensemble to receive a star 1. Emily Ho Everett, in band for 1 year, chorus for 1 year, performing with the trumpet ensemble to receive a star 1 and the show choir to receive a 1. Jacer Hudson in band for 1 year, pep band for 1 year, and trumpet ensemble receiving a Star One. Owen Jennis was in band or is in band for 1 year, low brass ensemble performing, receiving a Star One. Peyton Johnson in band for 1 year, performing with the flute ensemble to receive a Star One. Bailey Koski in band for 1 year, and she was also chosen to partake in honors band this year. French horn ensemble, Star One. Nicholas Luker in chorus for 1 year, performing with the show choir to receive a One. Eric Mackey in band for 1 year, pep band 1 year, and honors band. He performed with the French horn ensembles to receive a Star One. Magdalena, is that, am I saying that right?
Magdalena.
Oh, good.
Known as Maggie.
Yep, known as Maggie. Maggie McKinnon, in band for 1 year, performing with the clarinets to receive a One, but she also performed in a duet, which received a Star One. Abigail Miller, in band for 1 year, performing with the clarinet choir to receive a One. Michael Mulligan, in band for 1 year, pep band 1 year, and jazz band for 1 year. The jazz ensemble received a Star One, and his saxophone ensemble also received a Star One. Antonio or Tino Ochetti, in band for 1 year, trombone ensemble received a One. Olivia Oliver, she was in chorus for 1 year, and she performed with the show choir to receive a One. Cy Olson has been in band for 1 year, in pep band for 1 year, and performed with the saxophone ensemble to receive a Star One. Cassandra Pace, in chorus for 1 year, performing with our show choir to receive a One. Mackenzie Primo, in band 1 year, saxophone ensemble, Star One, and also a saxophone duet that got a Star One. Jacob Povolo, in band for 1 year, performing with our percussion ensemble to receive a Star One. Charlotte Ryan, in band for 1 year, saxophone ensembles, they received a Star One. Jacob Sari has been in band for 1 year, jazz band 1 year, and the jazz ensemble and the saxophone choir both received a Star One. Ethan Shazinski, in band for 1 year, and low brass ensemble, received a Star One. I didn't mess up his name. That was good. That's a tough one, too. All right, next up is Autumn Slyke. She's been in band for 1 year, in pep band for 1 year, and she performed in the percussion ensemble to receive a Star One, and also performed in the trombone ensemble to receive a One. She was also in a trombone duet that received a One. Galen Slyke is in band for 1 year, pep band 1 year, and performed with the trumpet ensemble to receive a Star One. Ali Sutton in Eiley. I do need glasses. Eiley Sutton, sorry, Eiley. In band for 1 year and percussion ensemble received a Star One. Austin Swanson, in band for 1 year, saxophone ensemble, Star One. Easton Teske, in band 1 year, low brass ensemble, Star One. Dominic Trulock, in band 1 year, pep band 1 year, and low brass ensemble, Star One. Brooklyn Turner, in band 1 year, pep band 1 year, jazz band 1 year. Jazz ensemble receiving a Star One, trombone ensemble also receiving a One, and a trombone duet receiving a One. Taylor Tursip-Hetsky, in chorus for 1 year, performing with the chorus show choir to receive a One. Lexi Frost, in band 1 year, trumpet ensemble to receive a Star One. And I believe that should do it for all of our ninth grade band and first members. So I will be turning it back over to Mr. Shirk to introduce the 10th graders.
Wonderful. Well, a couple of things I thought about that you might be curious about is, what are these large ensembles? During the class, from Christmas time or after vacation till solo ensemble, each of the sections divides up and goes into a room and practices music on their own. Usually they have a senior or one of the musically confident kids, direct them, and then Mr. Glindo and I, or Mr. Hunt that came this year, Mrs. Rice came this year, those are the volunteers that I talked about that come in and help us all the time. They come in and work with the kids and give them pointers, and then the kids work that stuff out. They practice art at home. And I have to say, they've just been excellent. They all go in Class A. Class A is very difficult. That's a hard high school level or easy college level type material. And they have to do the practice and put it together on their own. And then they come out on the stage and perform for a judge. So I think that's really important that you understand that they do a lot of that on their own individual work. I was just thinking that as you went by, maybe they didn't know about that. So now we're up to the second year, and I should make a little clarification. It's not necessarily sophomores, although we put it there. This can be anybody that joined late, and we'll see that a little more required. Sometimes they'll bob in and out for a year and then be out and then come back in, stuff like that. So these are two-year awards, primarily sophomores. You might notice too, as we go along, that their list kind of grows, the things that they do. The average kid coming in as a freshman, they're just checking out, seeing what it's going to be. You don't get too many like Brooklyn Turner, who's in three different groups and does a solo and duet and stuff like that, until they start getting older and start feeling a little more confident. So we're going to start out with Madison Beck. Madison Beck has been in the band for 2 years. She's been in the pep band this year, first time, and the flute choir, now Star One. Star One, by the way, the star indicates that they're eligible to go to state solo ensemble, which we usually participate at UWGB. Joshua Benz. Joshua has been in band for 2 years, been in pep band for a year, he's in jazz band for 2 years, he was in the honors band this year. That's another thing that might need a little bit of description. Yeah. The honors band, this is the Menominee River Conference. We have almost 13 schools in our conference now. We started from three. It was originally Norway, Iron Mountain, and Kingston. And as our conference grew, so did the demand for good musicians. So they decided to put together a high school honors band. This year, they hired Owen Williams, who is a composer, to come to Kingston, actually, it's held in Niagara, and write a piece of music just for that group, which the Menominee River Conference paid for by the kids' dues, and then they perform it. So each school is allowed to select a percentage of their group. So when you hear honors band, these are kids that dedicated a weekend to come in and practice. They sit all day long, long Saturday, and do a concert at the end. So it's a great honor to even be asked to do it, and even greater honor to be able to participate in it. So Josh did that, plus he got a star one in jazz band, he got a one in the trombone ensemble, and he went to district, and here is one of the kids who went to state. There are only four students that you're going to hear as we go along that did the virtual online state solo ensemble competition. Josh got a two there, he's an excellent trombonist, and kudos to him for taking that chance. That's a big deal to do that. And Emma Bilgreen. Emma's been in the band for 2 years, been in the pep band here, the honors band, she's a flute choir, and she also was in her recorder ensemble. Yeah. Four kids that got together, it was really cool. They had bass recorders and soprano recorders, and all kinds of things, and they got a two in that. Also Marcus Doucette. Marcus has been in the band for 2 years, in pep band for a year, and in the low brass ensemble, which of course got a star one, two, under the direction of Mr. Hunt. And Owen Dunn. Owen Dunn has been in band for 2 years. He's in the saxophone choir, got a star one today. Just a little aside, Owen also played a bass clarinet for us at concert season, and we're grateful for that. Actually, I think Owen was in the clarinet ensemble this year. I'm not sure. If he was, they got a one in that too. Elizabeth Early. Elizabeth has been in band 2 years. She's in the jazz band. This is the first year. She played the alto saxophone, though she's normally a flute player. She was a squad leader, was in the honors band, and she got a star one in the flute ensemble, star one in the jazz band, star one in her own flute ensemble, and she was the second of four people that went to virtual state solo ensemble, where she got a perfect score, all ones. Quite incredible. Joe Erickson. Joseph was in band for 2 years, he was in pep band for 2 years, and he was in the trumpet ensemble getting a star, one. Levi Fiorucci, 2 years in band, was in the saxophone choir, star one, was a tenor sax player. James Freeman was in a band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, in the French horn choir, got a star one, and he did a French horn solo, got a star one. Aaliyah Garvalia. Aaliyah's been in band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, she's in a clarinet choir and got an A1. She's also in our drum line, which makes her a leader coming up this year. Christina Hansen. Christina's been in the band 2 years, playing in the French horn choir, receiving a star one. Natalie Joski. She's in chorus for 1 year and in a concert chorale in the swing choir where they got a one. Devin Krajewski. Drevin has been in the band for 2 years, is in the pep band for 1 year, was a squad leader, and was in the percussion ensemble that earned a star one. Dalton Lawler. Dalton's been in the band 2 years, the pep band 2 years, the jazz band 2 years, was in the honors band, was in the, and received a star one and a two in the recorder ensemble. And I think he was kind of the motivator behind that recorder ensemble. He's a guy that likes to play many instruments. The jazz band, he plays the trombone, and the concert band, he plays the bassoon, and so ensemble, recorder. He likes weird plans. Jacob Loebner. Jacob's been in the chorus for 2 years. He did a tenor solo where we see the one in Class A. He was in the swing choir, he sang the one in Class A, and he was in Wisconsin Singers. Ella Lorenzoni. Ella's been in the band for 3 years, and she got a star one with saxophone ensemble. Daniel Mackey has been in the band for 2 years, the pep band for 1 year, squad leader, and honors band. He's been in the French horn choir, where actually he pretty much leads it. He's a section leader. He did a French horn solo, got a star one, and he's the other third of the four who went to state and got a one in Class A at state. He's also kind of a groundbreaker for us in that he takes horn lessons online from a lady downstate. And we encourage our other French horn players, if they want to, she would love to give lessons to our students too. Cassie McMahon, she's been in band for 2 years in the clarinet choir and got a one in Class A. Maggie Mangini has been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, and in the percussion ensemble where she got a star one. Allie Metris. Allie's been in the band for 2 years, was in the honors band this year, and was in the class clarinet choir where they also got a one in Class A. Andrew Morgan has been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, and the trumpet choir where he got a star one under the direction of Barb Rice. And Chick's computer froze up. No? Hey, there's another thing, just a little aside. I've moved up into the digital age, yeah. Normally we did all this on paper, but computers, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Louisa Menouz-Ozello, quite a lineup here. In the band for 2 years, the pep band for 2 years, the jazz band for 2 years, participated in the honors band. The trumpet choir, she got a star one, jazz band, star one, jazz combo, star one, jazz, or a trumpet solo, star one, and she was the fourth person who went to state and got a one at state. That's an amazing record for a sophomore.
Yeah.
Megan McKay. Megan's been in band for 2 years, was in pep band for 1 year, and in the saxophone choir where she got a star one. Abigail Nichols. Abby's been in the band for 2 years and in the clarinet choir getting a one in Class A. Michael O'Keddy. Michael's been in the band for 2 years, pep band for 2 years, jazz band for 2 years, and the honors band. He's in the percussion ensemble and the jazz ensemble, both receiving star ones at state. Amber Peterson has been in the band for 2 years, was in the trumpet choir and received a star one. Megan Preston has been in the band 2 years and was in a flute choir where she received a star 1. Zach Rankin is in the band for 2 years, the pep band for 2 years, the jazz band for 2 years, the honors band. He was in the trumpet choir, the jazz band, received star 1, was also in the recorder ensemble, receiving the 2 in class A. Alexander Reed. Alex has been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band this year, and was also in the trumpet choir, receiving star 1. Rhiannon Reed. Rhiannon was in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 1 year, in the saxophone choir, receiving star 1, and in the saxophone trio, receiving 2 in class A. Abigail Richard. Abby's been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 1 year, a squad leader in the honors band, and she received a star 1 in the French 1 choir. Evan Rittenhouse Witkowski.
Witinski.
Witinski. Witinski.
Yeah.
You stood there and waited to correct me.
Yeah.
You're a bad person. Concert Corral. He received his 1 in the swing choir and was also the bass section leader. Olivia Rundell. Olivia's been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, in the jazz band for 1 year, receiving a star 1 in both the percussion ensemble and the jazz ensemble. Sydney Scott. Sydney's been in the band for 2 years, honors band this year. She received a 1 in the clarinet choir, class A, and was in a clarinet duet, and received a 1 in class B. Laura Shields. Laura's been in the band for 2 years, in the pep band for 2 years, in the saxophone choir. She received a star 1 and a 2 in a class A saxophone trio. Haley Spigarelli, likewise in the band for 2 years, pep band for 2 years, was in the saxophone choir and did an alto sax solo, receiving a star 1 in both, and was in a saxophone trio, receiving 2 at the class A level. Matthew Wilson. Matthew was in band for 2 years, pep band for a year, low brass ensemble, and tuba ensemble, those are the same ensemble, sorry, receiving a star 1. Blake Wanford. Blake was in the band for 2 years, pep band for 1 year, low brass ensemble, receiving a star 1, and recorder ensemble, the last of the 4, receiving a 2 in class A. And that concludes our 2 year award winners, and I'll pass it on to you.
All right, so after our 2 years, we have our 3 years, even though it says juniors, keep in mind these are our 3 years. So, first up, we have Samuel Bilgreen. Sam's been in band for 3 years, in pep band for 2, and performed with our saxophone choir to receive a star 1. Let's see, just lost my spot. Next up, I think, was Bianca Byers.
It was.
Right. All right, let me find her again. So, Bianca Byers, in band for 3 years, pep band for 1 year. She was also a squad leader and was chosen for honors band. She performed with our clarinet ensemble to receive a star 1. Here we go, I got my spot. All right, oh good, because the next one is Catherine Erickson.
That's a lot of black and white on the screen.
It sure is. So, let's break it down. Catherine's been in band for 3 years, jazz band for 3 years. She's been in pep band for 1 year. She has been chosen for not only squad leader, but to be in honors band as well. She performed in the saxophone choir, the jazz band, the jazz combo, the percussion ensemble, and a saxophone solo, all of which to receive a star 1. Amazing.
Yeah. Actually, that wasn't a saxophone solo, it was a piano solo.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, amazing. Oh. Chopin's Nocturne in B-flat.
Yeah, and I listened to that. It was beautiful.
Yeah, it was.
Okay. Next is Sam Goucher. She has been in band for 3 years, pep band 3 years. She has been squad leader and honors band. She has performed with our trombone ensembles to receive a 1. Janik Hudson, in band for 3 years, received a Star One with the saxophone choir. Mariah Hall, band for 2.5 years. I can't zoom in on my phone, so the screen is real.
I know.
Sorry, Mariah. Band for 2.5 years, in pet band for 1 year, and she performed with our Low Brass this year, which received a Star One. Alexis Jacko, in band for 3 years, pet band 2 years. She was squad leader and also performed with our Low Brass ensemble, which received a Star One. And if I am not mistaken, she was all of this year our attendance taker as well. Is that correct, in band?
Yes, she was.
Yeah,
she
and that is a huge help. She did a phenomenal job. So.
Every day, 120 kids. Yes. See them all, figure out where they're at, what they're doing, and she does a phenomenal time. She
amazing.
Knows all the kids.
So, thank you. We then have Matthew Kiba in chorus for 2 years. He did a bass solo in German for the district level solo, and he received a Star One. He was also performing in our show choir, which received a One. Bennett Klossner, in band for 3 years, pet band for 2 years, performing with the French Horn Ensembles to receive a Star One. Next up is Dylan LaValle, in band 3 years, pet band 3 years, performing with our percussion ensemble to receive a Star One. Jane McAllister, band for 3 years, pet band 2 years, chosen to be a squad leader and performed in our flute choir to receive a Star One. Connor Morgan, band for 3 years, pet band 3 years, jazz band 3 years. Also was a squad leader, performed in our jazz ensemble and trumpet ensemble, both of which receiving a Star One. Caden Poulsen, he has been in band for 3 years, pet band for 3 years, and Caden performed with the trombone ensemble to receive a One. Cecilia Pickett, in band for 2.5 years, pet band for 1 year. She performed with our clarinets to receive a One. Ariana Presley. Ariana joined the chorus halfway through this year. She performed with our show choir, which received a One, and also had a vocal solo, a soprano solo, that received a Star One. Sarah Rivera, in band for 3 years, pet band 2 years, and clarinet choir, a One. Caitlin Rochon, in band for 3 years. She was a squad leader and performed in our percussion ensemble to receive a Star One. Carly Rundell. Carly's been in band for 3 years. She's been chosen for honors band and she performed with our low brass ensemble to receive a Star One. Next is Derek Sorovi, in band for 3 years, in pet band for 3 years, in jazz band for 2 years. He has been a squad leader and has played in the honors band. He has performed with our trumpet choir, our jazz ensemble, both of which receiving a Star One, and also performed a trumpet solo, Class A, to receive a Two. Madison Steinbeck. She has been in chorus for 2 years and performed with our show choir to receive a One. Jennifer Watson. She has been in band for 3 years, pet band 2 years. She has also been in chorus for 3 years. She was a squad leader this year and clarinet choir. She got a One. She performed a vocal alto solo. I believe that one was in French. She got a Two. Concert chorale show choir. She got a One. And then we have Lydia Wilson, in band for 3 years, pet band 3 years, and jazz band 2 years. She's performed in our saxophone choir to receive a Star One. And that will conclude all of our 3 years. So I'll send it back over to Mr. Schiff for one of our first seniors.
Wow. I suppose another little explanation. So our jazz band has been meeting for the last 3 or 4 years at 6:15 in the morning. And I don't know, a lot of kids do that kind of stuff in, yeah, in periods of time through the year. But we start the second week in September, and we don't end until about the second to the last week in May. Yeah. So they go all year long, 6:15 in the morning. Then you get a kid that has a combo, they're in by 7 o'clock in the morning, another day of the week. And then we have students that will come in, like Catherine Erickson and Mackenzie Rundell. They came in and helped with the middle school jazz band at 7.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So the awards are just slightly different, and I suppose I'd like to get it out of the shadow. So if they're in the jazz band, their first year, they receive the Large Lyre. Second year, they receive, Chenille eighth note, and their third year they get a jazz tune put on it. Likewise, in pep band, their first year they get a chenille note, and then every year after that they get a chevron. So if you're wondering what the kids are getting as they open up their packets, that's what comes with them. These medals up here are for state soul and ensemble that we said our four kids that did that will receive this year. That being the case, can you imagine the hours that some of these folks put in by the time they reach their fourth year? You figure 4 or 5 football games at 4 to 5 hours a piece. You figure 4th of July parades at maybe 3 hours plus 4 or 5 more hours of practice. You figure Christmas concerts, jazz band plays out in the community. You're really talking hundreds of hours of time that these students put into the department and into themselves. And what do they get out of it? They become leaders. They don't have to have the label of section leader or drum major or squad leader to become a leader. After all these years of doing this, they are leaders by the way they act. They are leaders by the way they deal with the kids under them. And we stress a real welcoming family environment. And these kids invite in the younger ones. And we're excited next year to see that already happening. There are kids that have been assigned buddies to the eighth graders coming up. And we're already starting to form the squad leaders next year. We have drum major auditions.
We do, coming up soon.
As a matter of fact, by the time you see this,
that's true,
they'll already have been done.
They will. So stay tuned.
Yeah. So with these, each of them get their own special picture along with what they got. We're just so grateful to have them. So we're going to start out with our first senior, Kate Cook. This is a picture I have hanging on my wall in my basement. And Kate had a chance. 10 minutes before we started this, I said, Kate, if you want to send that picture in, I said, oh, I've got one of you, Kate. She said, I trust you, Mr. Shirk.
10 minutes ago.
Kate. Anyway, what a wonderful young lady. Not just in all the stuff that you see up on the board, but as a person. She always has a smile on her face. She puts up with my garbage, which I give her all the time, just like that picture. She doesn't sit up straight when she plays, but she's a fantastic player and a wonderful person. Receiving after 4 years of band, 4 years of jazz band, squad leader, saxophone choir, and jazz ensemble this year for the first year. By the way, seniors get a plaque. I don't know how much that, but they'll have a plaque with their name on it. Hopefully they'll display that proudly for the rest of their lives. Ashley Brannon. Ashley's been in chorus for 4 years and concert chorale, receiving a 1 in Class A. Delaney Harris. Delaney Harris, oh, I'm sorry.
No, that's
you. That's you.
So we had an agreement before this that I would get the chorus seniors, but
you didn't even pop in when I said Ashley's name.
You know what they say, they don't interrupt old people. I know, it's your last year, I'll be nice. I figured you could have it. Ashley Branham has been in chorus for 4 years, and she's been an absolute pleasure to deal with. She is the first person to always give me sass, and the first person to correct the section when it needs it. Delaney Harris has also been in chorus for 4 years. She has went on to do incredible things. She has already performed incredible things. She did a soprano solo and a musical theater solo, both receiving a star 1. She was also chosen this year as our alto section leader, which she did a really great job at.
She also sang with the Honors Jazz Band
Oh, yes, she did.
Over near Mountain at the Candiani concert.
Yep, and it was beautiful.
Brought the house down. It was amazing. And she also performed with Mr. Hunt's jazz quartet. She's performed with them a couple years ago.
And you know, that doesn't surprise me at all. Delaney is a performer true and true. She will
be. Loves the stage.
Absolutely. Next up is you.
All right. Mallory Early. Now, there is an example of a young lady who started, we'll say it here, late in life. She was a freshman when she came in to start playing. And the first couple of years were just kind of staying in there and working. And after 4 years, become a very productive member of our band. And you're going to hate to see her go. 4 years of band, 3 years of pep band, was a squad leader, and received a star one in the saxophone. Josh Freeman. Now here's a guy that's very quiet and rarely talks. And the great thing about being on these Zooms is that he had to talk to me finally after 8 years of Josh, yes, no, yes. I asked him a question, he had to turn on the microphone. So I'm very proud of you, Josh. Nice job. 4 years of band, 4 years of pep band, and a star one in the trumpet ensemble. Seth Garrick. Seth, actually, I don't know if he's been in for 4 years. Might have been in for 2 years. He's in and out a couple of times and has just been a real asset to our group. He plays the alto saxophone, thus getting star one in the choir, but also band, pep band for 2 years. Maybe he wasn't band for 4 years. I have to check on that, Seth.
I'd also like to say, too, Seth will every single day come in and wish us a great day.
Oh, not just that. He always brings me a fruit.
Yeah, me too.
Apple, orange, pear, every single day.
This kid, every day, will make a point to stop in and try to brighten your day, and that speaks volumes to
that's
his character.
Leadership.
That is.
It's amazing.
Absolutely.
Yeah. God.
Nice job.
I've been out of school for a while. Edit that out. Okay. So our next student is Kyla Gauthier. Kyla has been in band for 4 years, a jazz band for 3 years, a squad leader, honors band, receiving two star ones, but the girl is one of the most amazing trumpet players. And I remember even back in eighth grade, when you hear her play, her tone was just so beautiful, and she was on the edge of not being in band. I'm just so glad that she came up and really put into our group, you know. When we need high, beautiful notes, call Kyla, come on and do this. She also stood on the square of the marching band.
Yeah.
And that's,
which is a lot harder than most people think.
Yeah, they do. They have to set the tempo for the entire band. And I have to say she did a great job this year. It's been a pleasure. Jada Goudreau. Here's another transplant. She came from Felch, can you believe? And boy, what a lot of growth we've seen in her. You see her here in the picture on her horse. She's amazing, what they call those equinarian.
That's
a great horse rider and has played trombone in the band for 4 years, and the pep band for 2 years, squad leader, and the trombone choir receiving a one in Class A.
Next up is Madison Artaud. Maddie has been in band for 4 years, and she is also chosen as our soprano section leader. And I do have to say that Maddie might be one of the most positive section leaders that I have in that group this year. She is not overjoyed all the time, but she is realistic and accomplishes her goals. She knows what it takes to get it done, and she leads her section there very, very well. So, and we need a lot of people like that, especially in music.
Do we have to graduate her? Can we just keep her?
Yeah, we can keep her.
This last quarter, sorry.
You'll come back. No, great job, Manny. Thank you.
Leah Hunter. Leah's been in band for 4 years, in the pep band for 2 years, a squad leader, honors band, trumpet choir star one. She's an amazing young lady. This year, she signed up to do peer-to-peer. Peer-to-peer means that a student is willing to come into any classroom and work with another student that might in some way be challenged academically and need some extra help. She's left her legacy by coming in. She's a very quiet young lady. And I have to say, one thing that we talk about in leadership is stepping out of our comfort zone. Leah stepped about as far out of her comfort zone as I think Leah could go, because and she would come in and she was in the sixth grade band, and in the classroom, all of a sudden at my door, I get seven people lined up. I need to read, my clarinet doesn't work, I don't know where my trumpet is. And I'm scrambling, trying to get these, so I get class going. I say, Leah, get up on the podium, run through a scale, play this. She's like, me? And I said, yeah, okay. And she gets up and does it. So I'm very impressed with her. She just did a great job. And she left her legacy. The kids that she worked with will remember her for the rest of their lives. Kendall Johnson, 4 years band squad leader and clarinet choir. This lady is on task all the time. I mean, she's one of those people that fits in that square box that has to have everything exactly right. You know, we're online Zooming and she, Mr. Shirk, I played through some of these parts a thousand times and I can't get that high score on smart music, which is very difficult because sometimes, you know, you get a little glitch in your internet. Right. Something doesn't line up.
Computers aren't perfect.
They aren't. And she's just amazing. She checks in and makes sure everything's going. However, I have to say, Kendall, in waiting to 2 minutes before we came on to do this to get that senior pitcher out of here, I was a little shocked.
Hey, but she got it.
I'm just saying, she got it. There it is. You bet. And Trinity Kinnaman. Trinity has been a band for 4 years, been a band for 2 years, squad leader, honors band, star one, and flute choir, also leader in that flute choir. It's just an amazing task. She comes from a family of six or seven brothers and sisters, and she homeschooled till middle way through middle school, and then popped in here. Takes real courage, and she really did a great job. I'm very proud of her. And then we have Harrison Klosner. I don't recognize him without hair on his face, but I guess he had to clean up for the senior shot. 4 years in band, 3 years in pep band, 2 years in jazz band, saxophone choir, star one. And Harrison and I share the passion of fishing together. As a matter of fact, even this past week, he was sending me pictures of bass, and I won't say where he got it, some very large, small bass. But he's also been a real asset to us on the very saxophone.
Absolutely.
There were times that I'd say, back up, back up, back up.
Which typically you don't do with that.
No, you're always saying give me more.
So.
Yeah, she did an amazing job. Thanks a lot, Harrison.
All right, next up is Dayton Cool. So Dayton actually only made it, well, he graduated a little earlier than everybody else. He was on a very specific program and track in life. So hopefully this video reaches him and he can see and share and experience all of this with us. He's been in chorus for 2 years and performed with our show choir. And I have to say, Dayton is one of the most caring and meticulous singers that I have met. He has always been like, well, how, when we do this, we should all do it exactly this way. And that kind of vision, that specificness is good to have, especially when most of the time our job is keep the whole group. We can lose sight of what everybody's doing with their fingertips. I don't know. So, great job, Dayton, and it was awesome to have you here.
So, Gavin Lieburn had been 4 years. Actually, I don't think he was. He came in later. And I actually pep band for 2 years in Little Brasca, star one. But in talking with the kids on Zoom, I said his girlfriend is Mallory Early.
Yep.
And I said, did you kind of come in and follow her? Because she didn't start till later. No. But we weren't going together. I said, I didn't know you weren't going together, but was it your plan? Oh, no. We just met. He said, most of my friends were in band, so they'd be sitting around talking about band stuff. And he said, I thought I'd better join. I'll tell you what, he said, great job. I heard him soloing. He was planning on taking over Ren Thorne's solo because Ren couldn't be at state.
Right.
So he was already practicing for that. And,
he was nervous, but man, did he sound, he sounded great.
He rose to the occasion. Stephanie List. Stephanie's in band for 3.5 years, in pep band for a year, and squad leader in the flute ensemble, getting a star one. She also played cymbals in the drum line, and it is an amazing. I spent all my time with the cymbal player saying, you need to learn to move, that's part of what we do. And most cymbal players sit there and do this, nothing personal, Rhiannon and Ella. They sit there and go like this, and you know, Stephanie's out there moving and shaking it up and stuff
she
like
has,
that.
Yeah.
And she really added a lot to that. She has a lot of personality. I know, I'll always remember his little puppy dog and the play she did in middle school. It was funny. Great job, Stephanie.
So next up is Christopher Maynard. Now, I've actually known Chris a lot longer than his 3 years in high school chorus. Back when I was a student here, he was real young, middle school, but even back then he had this ambition and drive and interest to learn everything he could about singing. And I remember him as a little middle schooler coming into the high school chorus and just watching and learning, and every now and then he'd ask a question, and of course all of us were, who's this little kid, but he has carried that motivation and that drive up through all of his years, and even now afterwards he will be the person who stays back and say, hey, can I help you? Hey, what do you think of this? How can I do better at this? And he's that next level, he really is. In chorus for 3 years, he's the tenor section leader on top of all of that, and performed in our show choir to receive a one.
Annabelle Miller, 4 years in the band and a star one flute, but draw your attention to this picture right here. So I had no picture for Annabelle, and I had to come up with something, and they sent me a card with all their pictures on it. So Annabelle comes in, and she's sitting in the arms of Caroline Taylor, and you'll see her picture in a minute.
Yeah.
And so, and they were in the far instrument room. I can tell you for 4 years, it was like every day, come on, you two, let's go. And you're back there talking and giggling and carry on. So I can imagine when they say, hey, we need a picture for you for shirts thing. So they snapped that and said, oh. So Annabelle's just really come a long way in 4 years. She's a great kid. But this picture, Annabelle, this picture. Did what I could, Annabelle. Logan Mitchell. Logan's been in band for 4 years, pep band for 2 years, squad leader, honors band, and received a star of one in the saxophone choir. Logan put together, I guess we could call it, the first virtual drum major audition.
Yeah.
Because, was it that he couldn't be there last year? Or
yeah, there was some reason that before all of this, he made a video for his audition for drum major last year, unbeknownst to all of us that there'd be many who'd have to follow in his footsteps. He set a really high bar.
He was the first one, so then actually he's going to do the video at the end of this awards ceremony.
So you will see a memory video that was done completely by him, so you will see his expertise.
It'll be excellent. And this year is kind of neat to watch him come in his senior seminar. I guess he's not good. Coming into the band room, and he would work with my fifth graders. It was really neat to see him step up and be willing to step out of his comfort zone, too, and did a great job.
Noelle Myers, she has been in chorus for 4 years and performed in our show choir to receive a one. Noelle was one of the couple girls that I would talk to about show choir choreography and things in the past and bounce ideas off of. Noelle really has this good artistic vision. I believe her mom is also co-heading up or helping with the drama department. So she has a nice musical family, supportive, enriching background, and she shows that and brings that to the table with this group. So thanks for all the help, Noelle.
And then of course there's Mario Ochetti. You'll notice this picture we had to steal from the senior lineup because I couldn't get Mario to send me a picture. I don't have a picture at home either, Mario. Thanks a lot. You can still send that. I'll take it. But Mario's in the band for 4 years, in the pep band for 4 years, in jazz band for 4 years, in squad leader, honors band. I think he co-led the drum line this year with Bryce Robinson. He's in the percussion ensemble, jazz band, jazz combo, he's a star one, all those. Just an amazing drummer and a nice kid. He worked hard at creating some of the drumline moves and working things out behind the scene and coming in, which takes extra work upon the extra work. So, I mean, there's a kid who's in jazz band, jazz combo, and percussion ensemble, which means another morning.
Yeah.
You know, it's a lot of time dedication, and Mario's done a great job. I know he's left his legacy with the kids that are around him. Just a wonderful kid. Peterson, 4 years, jazz band, 4 years, honors band, low brass ensemble, star ones and everything, and tuba solo. He's just an amazing, he's been getting star ones and tuba for 4 years for sure, and I can't remember if he did in the eighth year or not. He also plays the trombone in the jazz band. Just an exceptional musician. But as you can see there, he has some hobbies that we share. I got that from him today. I said, Daniel, send me a picture. I don't have a picture. So he sent me this walleye that he caught at a spot that he actually showed me this year.
Really?
Ooh, yeah, I saw it. Yeah. This is a 25-inch walleye that he caught at the special.
Just a little taste of retirement.
Big taste of retirement. Yeah. So, and he's also, he was just talking about buying a new truck and how to fix that. I see him on the road all the time with his head under the hood. He drives all these old beater Catalinas and stuff like that. Anyway, he's just been a real asset to our group and has brought a lot to us. Bryce Robinson, 4 years of band, 3 years of pep band, 4 years of jazz band, squad leader, honors band, percussion ensemble, jazz combo. You heard me say all that with Mario. This guy came in to play jazz, plays percussion in the concert marching season, but plays guitar in a jazz band. He came in as a freshman. Sorry, Bryce, not so good. But Mr. Hogan's string class, he learned and practiced. One of the kids that actually practiced in the class and worked hard and did really quite well. And to the point that he's certainly one of the top five guitarists that I've had over the past 30 years in jazz band.
Let me jump in here and say that we are still looking for a guitar player for jazz band next year. And Bryce has told me personally that he would teach you everything he knows if you're even a little interested. So this is your opportunity to learn from one of the masters.
Everything Bryce knows. That'll be a 5-minute lesson. What? Did I say that? But he deserves that. So we were talking the other day, and he had a bunch of true confessions shared. I won't say all of them, but one of them was, and I say this to Mrs. Nomad too, I never wore the right socks ever once in a performance. Nice. We'll catch you next time, Bryce. We'll follow you to the next life. Anyway, great kid. And next, Mackenzie Rundell. Mackenzie's been in the band for 4 years, the pep band 4 years, jazz band 2 years, drum major, honors band, was in the trombone ensemble, the jazz band, low brass. She also did a alto solo, which for whatever reason isn't on the list.
Oh, yeah.
Did she get a star one in that or one?
I don't know.
I think she got a star one. She did, because I remember she looked at my face. Hey, Sherry, he said I couldn't do it. He said I couldn't do it. Well, I guess you proved me wrong. Whatever it takes a motivated person, that's it. You know, I can handle it. I can be humble in this career. She's just a really diligent, hard worker. She was a drum major this past year. And plays both the trombone and the saxophone, so whatever I needed at the time, she was able to play. I think she played both of those instruments in the jazz band at different times. And helped me with the middle school jazz band, come in the morning, copy music, because middle school kids don't know how to keep up their music with them. And just a great kid to have around. Elizabeth Ryan, 4 years band, 2 years pep band, squad leader, honors band, clarinet choir, you know, star one clarinet choir. This year she led it. Last year she led it. Well, maybe she didn't, but they got an exemplary award in clarinet ensemble. And this year they got
This year they got one. Last year they did get it. They got
a star one in here.
Right.
Right. So clarinet choir got one, but just an amazing kid. Really led her kids. And this year I said, I don't have any clarinet players. And Pep is voluntary. You know, that's another one that we play at five home girls and five home boys basketball games. And if somebody in the community wants us, we'll occasionally get out and play something like that. But I said, I don't have any clarinet players. And she wasn't like, okay, she said, I'll go. And all of a sudden we had four or five clarinet players, which means leadership by doing is very important. So thank you for that, Lizzie. Oh, I just skipped. I pulled one.
You don't want me to
take it? I got it. No, I can handle it.
Oh, come on.
I can handle it.
I can take this guy.
Eli Salini. director's award, but did you get that, 8th grade?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. So Eli Steen was in a band for 4 years, a pep band 4 years, jazz band 5 years.
Yep, he's a special.
Eli Steen started playing bass in his 8th grade year. He played this. I think the most amazing bass player in jazz band I've ever had, bar none.
That's huge.
He's just done a fantastic job. He's been squad leader, honors band. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 star ones. That may be the most that we had this year. He did not go to state, shame on you, Eli, should have. But he did receive almost, I think, if not a full ride to Lawrence in tuba performance. Again, since 8th grade, he's been going to state solo ensemble, getting star ones on his tuba, plays bass, just totally amazing. He started the tuba line this year, first time, I hope that they keep doing it, but I know a lot of our tuba players are football players, so it's going to be a little hard for the marching season, but Eli, nice job. Logan Smith. Logan has been in the band for 4 years, the pep band 4 years, the jazz band for his squad leader, honors band, saxophone, choir, solos, combo, the whole list. There are a couple things that make me think of him, particularly though, his leadership in 8th grade, he had a jazz combo. We haven't had one since, and he pretty much led it himself. He picked out the music. He did that again this year in the jazz combo. But it just always stayed in my mind, especially as an 8th grader, to have that kind of organization, thought, and creativeness, and be able to pull it together. It's always very proud of him. You can see him there in the picture. He has a soprano sax. He bought that one himself, and a tenor sax also. Just a tremendous player. Ben Stanich, 4 years of band, 3 years of pep band, 4 years of jazz band. He's in the jazz ensemble, the combo, trombone ensemble, low brass, star ones and all those. Ben is also, as you can see with this picture, he gave us a football player. And I'll tell you what, it's not easy to juggle football, weightlifting, all this stuff, and then come to jazz band at 6:15 in the morning. He's just been a real asset that way. And I know that jazz band was his love, but he also supported us in everything else he did, so way to go. Maggie Strader, 4 years band, squad leader, two star ones, a saxophone trio. That trio's been going for all 4 years. I think they even started, they missed 1 year, but they started in 8th grade with that saxophone trio. And her and Caroline and Kate Cook, I think, are the ones that have been doing that for years. So this year they got a star one in their trio, and they also started a quartet and got a star one in that. She's just a tremendous person. Again, very busy athletically, but able to put in time and be with the band, and we're just real proud of her, grateful that she's here. Luke Stern, 4 years band, 3 years pep band, 2 years jazz band, all-star ones, clarinet, solo, choir, and just done a tremendous job. See there, a picture with me. He was drum major this year. Luke just, you know, I guess I would say walk softly, carry a big stick, or speak softly, because he doesn't say much. And then when he finally talks, everybody listens. Very important, and a very impressive kid. He leads by example. He's part of everything.
Yeah.
Great to have you, Luke. Caroline, this is the other half of the picture with Annabelle Miller. You can't see it, but Annabelle's arm is actually around her neck, so I had to, because Caroline didn't send me a picture. 4 years of band, star one in saxophone choir, star one in trio, star one in quartet. She just really came a long ways this year. I think she made it up to second chair, I'll be honest, I didn't expect it, Caroline. You worked really hard, obviously, and you did the job, and you've just been a sweet kid. She's really into horses and stuff like that. She raises the 4-H and then sells cows and stuff like that. So I'm really excited, and I think she's going to be a vet, and I think you'll be a great vet. Thank you for being with us. Ren Thorne. Red Thorn, 4 years band, 3 years pep band, squad leader, honors band, low brass, star one. He also was in a duet with Eli that received the star one. And I think I accidentally pulled that out. I think it was supposed to be in there. I think I might have erased that one since it was in there. But yeah, he's just done a great job. He came over from Norway, and you know, there were times when his folks owned the Swedish print shop in Norway. I'm having a moment here, a senior moment. Swedish Passport, I think it's called.
Oh.
And so they did up our t-shirts for the last 3 or 4 years, and Ren was the one that designed a lot of them, put them together. He'd be the go-between, also the jackets that we have now became from him and his mother, who put them together and designed them. So in addition to being a great musician, first chair in this section, he also really enhanced the band by bringing to us his gifts and talents. He's just a tremendous guy. And I think he's going to go on to UM.
Ooh,
UM Marching Band, you betcha. Jaden Weber, 4 years of band, 3 years of pep band, 2 years of jazz band. He was in, and got star one in the jazz and sax ensemble. Here he is in his middle school attire. He comes out of the picture and said, "Hey, Sheriff, look at this. There he comes." He hasn't changed much. Oh, wait, I said that. And, you know, amazing kid. We went out on the field and we were playing a song 1 year, and he was just able to start playing it, and we all learned to dance to it. I think it was last year. That was a lot of fun. He plays harmonica. I tried to get him to do a jazz band, but I never got him to do a jazz band. But just a tremendous young man, lots of energy, very creative, funny, and always going places. Thanks, Jay.
Okay, so brings us to our next section, which we have the Special Senior Music Awards. Let's give a little insight about what each of these awards are first before we break down who gets what. So these awards are exemplary, outstanding, very specific students who fall into a very special categories. There's a special name for each of them, but each one represents something completely unique and important for all of our musical aspects. Brainstorm with me, make sure we have all of them. The Arian Award is an award given to someone who encompasses all of music. That could mean multiple instruments, that could be singing, that could mean all kinds of things. The Arian is the all-around go-to musician. Is that correct?
That's right.
Yeah.
And very strong.
Very strong. Absolutely. Do you want to name off all the awards first, or should we get to the next?
No, let's get to it.
All right. So, for the Arian Award, like we explained, this person is an all-around musician. This person has performed on, he's been an instrumental player in our team. He has done not only bass drum, percussion ensemble, to clarinet in the clarinet ensemble. He performed in our jazz band playing tenor saxophone. He was also in our pep band. He was in. He was one of our drum majors this year. He went on to conduct. He has been instrumental and very strong in all of his performances. And like Mr. Shook was saying, during his time as drum major, even outside of the school itself, he's not really known to speak tons and tons, but he does very well in what he does, and everything he does is with purpose, especially the music. And he is all-encompassing when it comes to music. So, nice job, Luke Stern. All right, now we're gonna go to the Choral Award. Okay, so the Choral Award, this person, you probably saw them already, is a born performer, and they have been performing since very, very young. And they have done more things that I could even imagine naming right now, but we even named some of them just a bit ago during her slide. She is a singer by trade. She plans on going forward and performing at the college level. I don't think she's decided exactly where yet, but she set her sights very high, and frankly, she has the choral prowess to accomplish that, as long as she sets her mind to it. The choral award is given to a student who embodies musicianship and performing and all kinds of vocal expertise. Delaney Harris has also been a section leader and a leader this year as well. And she's helped share her knowledge and performance capabilities with the rest of the group, and that's huge. So,
I would add to that that she takes private lessons.
Oh yes, yeah,
friends and someone has been with her.
And during solo ensemble time, it would be at least most often more, but at least once a week, she would be giving up her lunch to practice in the classroom with Don Kranz during the school day. That's not counting anything else that she has going
very
on.
Very dedicated,
all the time. So, choral award is going to Delaney Harris.
Right on. All right, so this one goes out to a person. Don Holmes is a man whose children went through our department. When he came in to watch him work, he was so enthralled with everything that went on here, with the family atmosphere, for the love of the kids and stuff, that he started donating his time. He would take all the bass drums home and fix them. He would rebuild some of our percussion equipment. His kids were in percussion, so that was his first love. And then he came along and decided he could help upgrade the night show, and that he did. Mm-hmm. His relentless servitude to our school is in great memory to this man who passed from cancer about 4 or 5 years ago. And we wanted to do an award that talked about somebody who embodies that same giving. Now, this recipient for this year's award is a young person who I would watch stay after performances or just in the afternoon, picking up the classroom, putting chairs in order, and asking me what he can do. I did talk about the fact that this young man also came in the afternoons and worked in my fifth grade. He put together videos, doing the video for this one. Just puts in a lot of time. I think he's a real behind the scenes servant.
You know, he's not in chorus, but he asks me all the time if there's anything he can do to help me.
Yeah.
And he's not even in my class.
Right. So, the Don Holmesy Holmes Senior Award goes to Logan Mitchell. Just a fine young man, a hard worker, and I know that's going to pay off in his future.
Oh, yeah.
Congratulations, Logan.
Next one should be the Louis Armstrong Award. That's you, right?
Oh, yeah. That's me again, huh?
Yep,
we are
strong.
All right,
sorry, go ahead.
It's not like they can't get, that's not true. We have 5 or 6 seniors in that jazz band. And I'll tell you what, 2 years ago, 2 years ago, the jazz band received one of those
exemplary
awards.
Yeah, exactly.
I never even knew they existed, and all of a sudden it came in the mail, and that means that you are one of hundreds, thousands, maybe, of events that gets recognized as being exceptional. And although all of our groups together make us successful, there's this group of 5 right now, the rhythm section, trumpet, a couple trombones, sax, that have just really pulled together. So trying to come up with, figuring out who is going to get a jazz award, it could go to so many of them. You saw the list. However, we did narrow it down and decided that this would go to the young man who has been supporting jazz through his combo leadership. So we'd like to give our Louis Armstrong Award this year to Logan Smith, who has really put in a lot of time and experimenting with soloing. Improvisation is the backbone, and he has learned and still learning. I hope he continues to. So congratulations.
Nice show.
The last senior award before we give our drum major award. This is so hard.
This one is tough.
First of all, the John Philip Sousa Award is a national award. It's awarded across the United States to people. John Philip Sousa was the director of the military bands and was one of the first marching bands that formed in the United States. And so this one comes with a high caliber performance, a high caliber of moral code, servitude for sure, leadership, exemplary behavior, and to be honest, I couldn't break it down into one. I couldn't do it. I threw a name, 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 and so finally we came up with two. Those two are Eli Saleem and Mackenzie Rundell. And I salute you. It's an award I have from when I was in high school. Mrs. Hogan had it. Did you get it?
Nope. I had the area, the all-around music.
Oh, you didn't say that. You could have said that.
No, I guess I could.
Look, it's following
you. This isn't about me.
Okay. All right. So, you know, it's with great honor and pleasure that I present the John Philip Sousa Award to two wonderful and deserving students, two of many, I think. But
absolutely.
Congratulations. Here we are to the Drum Major Awards. Let me tell you, this is a real personal event for me and for Mr. Glendale. Both of us are drum majors in high school and in college, and we know the work that you put into it. We know that our drum majors are completely in charge of the band, and they've earned the respect, and let me tell you, these two have really done that. They've lived up to the standards of the drum majors before them. It's their job to learn the music, to know the kids, to be able to direct the drill. Basically, they are band directors on the field. So we're very grateful. We have two awards to give today to our two drum majors, both of them graduates, to Luke Sturm, who has just done a fabulous job. And you know, he's a guy who carries a big stick, but speaks softly. And the kids listen when he talks, they know what he's gonna say. And Mackenzie brings all kinds of energy and a real finesse to the position of drum major. So to both of you, we want to say thank you for a great year. You have earned these, you deserve these, and I hope that you display them with pride in your future. And we just ask you all the best. And that's going to bring us to you guys, who are now going to present the passing of the pants.
Good evening, everyone. We hope everyone is safe and healthy. This year has been full of ups and downs. We went through highs and lows with each other.
Normally, this speech involves asking the entire band to stand up as we go through our infamous Heels Together speech. Unfortunately, we are not able to do that this year. However, we ask that you do so in spirit one last time.
Heels.
Together.
Together we stand. Together we form a family. Together we are one band, one sound. Together we make too many memories to count. We are all able to pull together Arabesque, The Witch and the Saint, and Americans We in such a short amount of time. Together we marched onto the football field on many cold Friday nights. Together we would always scream, "Let's get naked," after we got back from a performance or parade. We always marched onto the practice field and football fields together, and we always left the field together.
Toes.
Apart.
Apart we are during this uncertain time. We are apart throughout the UP. We are apart physically, but in spirit we shall never be. When the seniors go to college or someone has to move schools, even though they are physically separated, the spirit of the Kingship Band holds us together forever. No matter where we are, no matter how far apart we may be, our chins always stay high with pride.
Stomach.
In.
In our lives, band helps us learn valuable skills. We learn friendship, leadership, and togetherness. Looking inward at the impact that being in band has given us shows us the value of it, and there is no stronger community than the KHS band. Most of us marched in step, no matter what time signature the music was in.
Chest.
Out.
Outward, the band has a great impact on our community. We bring life to football games and basketball games, play beautiful music for our community at our concerts free of charge, and build upon Kingship's positive reputation at competitions. The value every member of the band brings to our school and our community is immense, and for that we want to thank every member. Our reputation also goes out farther than our local community. All around the UP, if you mention the Kingsford Marching Band, ears perk up. Of course, if there's an opportunity to talk about band, most of us will do so.
Shoulders.
Back.
Back in time we go to remember the fun times we've all had. We go back to our very first band week, where we learned how to backwards roll step, which, honestly, who actually does? We go back in time to our very first football game as part of the Kingsford Marching Band. All those nervous jitters and anxiousness. Then, the show began, and before we knew it, it was band day. Every show between brought a fresh set of jitters and many new memories.
Chin.
Pride.
Prideful we are of the memories we created. Prideful we are with the many halftime shows we have performed. Prideful we are as we close the school year with a bang. Prideful of the family we've created. Think back to band week and remember where we started, and then look at how far we've come. Putting on an excellent performance at Band Aid, an amazing Christmas concert, almost every group making it to Solon Ensemble States, and we were playing Arabesque beautifully before the school year abruptly ended.
Chin.
Pride.
We are proud of the many accomplishments we have made. We all first started out not knowing what his instrument was, and we are ending it, well, we were supposed to end it, with Arabesque. Although we did not get to perform one last time at our spring concert, we are proud of how far we came together on such a difficult piece. We are proud of our school and the Kingsford Marching Band.
Chin.
Pride.
Prideful we are as we say goodbye to our band family. Prideful we are as the seniors finally finish high school. Prideful we are to be part of such a loving, caring, and hopeful group. We will never forget our KHS marching pride.
We wish that we could have ended up in the auditorium during this year's awards. We wish that we could have set our final heels together. We wish that we were able to pass the pants like we were supposed to. With that being said, we plan on actually passing them as soon as the stay-at-home order is lifted. So first, let's virtually pass the pants.
This person I have known since they started high school. They have had a huge influence on my high school experience and an even bigger influence on band. This person has really come out of their shell this year and showed their true potential as a leader. This person has helped me out on numerous occasions, especially when it comes to band. I have had the opportunity to get to know this person on a personal level, and they have become one of my greatest friends. I am very proud to say that your first drum major for the 2020-2021 season is Samantha Gaucher.
The next person I have worked with a lot over the past 3 years. Every time they are involved in anything, I see them taking charge and making sure that everything goes smoothly. Since they were an underclassman, this person worked with the leaders in the band to achieve great things. Their ambition and honesty has helped bring their section to a higher level. I am proud to announce that the second drum major will be Dylan Lavalley.
Congratulations to the both of you. We know that the band is in good hands, and we wish you the best of luck this next year.
We thank you for letting us be your drum majors, and we hope that we have left a lasting impression on every member of the band. Now, to finish off the 2020 Music Awards, we pass it off to Senior Logan Mitchell with a 2020 memory video. Please enjoy, and we will miss you.
Such a weird dream.
What time is it?
It's 2:45 p.m.
Crap! You know what that means? I'm late for online!
Ah, Power of man. That's the power of man.
Sounds good today.
All right, let's see if I made it today. Nice. Yes, 3 o'clock. That is a new record. I'm so proud of myself.
Hey Google, what are my notifications for today?
You have a notification from Ben Shuck. Go to the Zoom meeting at 3:10 p.m. Important info.
Really? What kind of info?
He said that he has an important time-related issue.
What does he have to do with the time problem? I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter. It's already 3:06 anyways. 3:10's not that long away.
I literally can't stand waiting.
Oh. It's already 3:10 anyways. Why do I care?
Let's just open up that Zoom meeting and click.
Hey Shirk, how's it going? Why don't you have your camera on?
He's typing in chat.
What do you mean you can't have your camera on or your mic? Doesn't make any sense, you have it on all the time. Whatever, I guess. Go outside of your house. I left you a present on the porch. Really? What kind of present did you leave? Okay. Guess I'll go check. Hold on, I'm gonna go put on my sweatshirt. Sure. It's pretty cold outside. Alright. I'm gonna go on the porch now.
Just looks like a saxophone. I mean, I might as well try it out, I guess. I'm sorry. Were you watching that? I'm just gonna... Hey everybody, I hope this video finds you well. Welcome to the 2020 Music KHS Music A Band Award Ceremony thing. I don't know what to call it. And congratulations to our new drum majors.
I dare you to clap.
Clap right now.
I have no idea if the drum majors have been elected yet. Shirk told me when this video was going to be planned, but, you know, I'm just stupid. As awesome as it would be to get a new saxophone in the mail from a mad scientist named Shirk, we can't do that. We can't go back in the past and prevent this pandemic or go back and see everyone that we want. Since we can't go back to the past or head into the future, let's take a moment and look back on some memories that we've made through music in our lives through the past few years, starting with 2020 and working our way back. So let's take a moment and reflect on our own. Reflect on a few things, seniors. Ha!
To start off the 2020 school year, we actually have to go back to last year during May 2019. Oh yeah, the drum major tryouts. And all the wannabes in the finals were Logan Smith, Ren Thorne, Luke Sturm, Kate Cook, Mackenzie Rundell, and me. Most importantly, me. At least I think that was all the people. Kate displayed her talent for being really loud. I showed off my talents of videos. Ren showed off his actual dominance of being an actual Chad. Logan showed off his perceptiveness, and Mackenzie and Luke showed that they were indeed the best, with maybe a few minor hiccups along the way. And at the pantsing, At the passing of the pants, Ethan and Merrill gave the pants to Mackenzie and Luke. And with that, we had our new drum majors. Impeach Mackenzie! In that summer, Mackenzie and Luke went to drum major camp, where they learned how to be actual drum majors instead of just flailing their arms to music and blowing into a whistle randomly. Oh wait, no, that's
what I did.
During this time, preparations for next year came, where we all got our new squads and new freshmen of the band, just to tell them that their plume is on backwards, which
it always is.
In the coming time, our new squads marched up for the In the coming time, our new squads marched for the Memorial Day parade along with Iron Mountain. And I don't think we had to sit through that one guy this year whose speech always says, "And the flag still waved!" We had a 2-hour delay. And the flag still waved! During the end of the summer, the middle of the open road program, aka Motor, was active. And during this time, I made documentaries for each day. And I probably got about 4 hours of sleep total through those 3 days because I was editing those videos like crazy. This was our freshmen's last year in Motor as campers. And now time for them to become counselors next year. If this year happens, that is.
Curse you, Corona!
This is so cringy. During Motor, we also got to meet and have fun with the high schoolers of tomorrow, aka the middle schoolers. Now it's time for August, and you know what that means? Band week, that's right. This is where we all got to become more than just squads, but family. Aww. Anyways, this year we decided to play the most complicated marching show known as Riverdance. The show was made of 3-ish pieces with a bucket part thrown in the middle for good measure. Fun fact, my cousins played this show all the way back in the good old days, and one of the people in their class fell and knocked over buckets multiple times. Anyways, we made sure there was barely any bucket tipping this time because we had new help from a new helper.
Mr. Galindo.
Okay, he probably wasn't the reason why all the buckets stopped tipping, but he helped a lot. With all this underway, our squad leaders and drum majors had a lot on their plates. However, did we manage this? By replaying set 1 4 million times over and over. But we got it. In October. With school starting back up, you know what that means. Go back to set 1. But actually, we worked our butts off until we finally got it. In the middle of all this, we had the light show. Night show? I'm just gonna call it the light show, because most of our shows are at night. This year, the light show was directed by Ren Thorne, who decided to do television. This show had to deal with Jeopardy and had Bryce Robinson as the host, asking questions leading to the songs that we were going to play. The guests were Iron Mountain, Kingsford, and the school that we were facing at the time. The songs we played were The Simpsons, Hawaii Five-0, Friends, and HBO's hit show? Whatever that is. And that was a jolly time. Why did I write that in? That's so stupid. Finally, we went to NMU for band day and did the show.
I was late. I had to ride with Walter.
Swell dude. Hey Walter, if you're watching. I don't remember the exact results at all, but I think we did good at the show. The only problem that we ever really had with that show was the buckets anyways, and I still think we did pretty good. Finally, marching season was over. Which, summing it up, marching season is so short, but it feels so much longer than concert season. With the Veterans Program Day coming up, that also meant cheering was coming up, which to our new freshmen was probably very different from middle school. For a Veterans Day program, we played The Stars and Stripes Forever by our boy, John Philip Sousa, and Eli had his sola from Badawagama on the tuba. Oh yeah, and so did Elizabeth on her piccolo. But look at that dumb instrument, and look at the tuba! Yes! With the program out of the way, came chairing, which is probably the most stressful time of the year, ever. And with that done, came the Christmas concert, where Shirk threatened to take away Sleigh Ride from us, even though it was honestly worse a year or two ago whenever we played it and had to restart during the concert. The band was split up into two groups and we were off. Shirk went out and did his Sugar Plum Fairy and addressed all the seniors in a big shebang. In a big shebang. I don't know what my writing is. Now catching up pretty close to where we ended up now, came stuff for spring concert and solo ensembles. We got our song Arabesque, Americans We, and Witch and the Saint. The groups all split up for solo ensemble, and that went fine for most of us. I had to direct the saxophones during practice, and
that was pretty scary.
But solo ensembles went fine, but then out of nowhere, this virus started emerging from the depths of Shanghai! Sorry. This ended up putting a damper on things because we got a 3-week break, which was pretty cool, but supposed to go to Florida! And the 3-week break turned indefinite, and now we're using stupid
thinking smart music! But seriously, big shout outs to Maxine for all the help organizing the Florida trip and the reschedule. It's really unfortunate that the seniors and Shirk couldn't finish their last year the way that we all wanted to, but we can't change things right now. We have to make the best of what we have right now and make it a great day. I wonder where I heard that before. So, to celebrate graduation and Shirk, let's look back on a few memories as seniors.
And I guess you other people can watch.